Hello everyone, this is Shreya, a member of Chugindi Times, the official campus magazine of CEG, STAP and ACT. I'm extremely delighted to welcome Mrs. Krishna Mitra ma'am, who is a visual artist and an interior designer by profession, currently leading design and execution in a family-owned design studio, Form and Function. Her artwork has been featured as the cover for India Today Home, and she's also written content for Asian Paints. Welcome, ma'am.
Hi, Shreya.
So, to start with, what actually inspired you to choose your path of designing?
So, actually, my mom is an interior designer. But somehow, right after school, I didn't decide to pursue it. I thought I'd go a conventional way, and I did my BBA at MOP Vaishnav. By the time I finished it, I knew that this was not the path for me. And I took a couple of years because when you're young, I think there's so much pressure to figure it all out. But you know, sometimes for some people, I needed to take a couple of years. I interned with an ad agency. I interned with a fashion stylist. I interned with my mom for a short while as well before I decided to pursue design. And then when I went to college, I knew, by the time I was there, yeah.
Okay, so what does art mean to you?
So art to me is an expression of an idea or thought or an emotion that other people, even if one or two people can relate to it, that's art to me. So
what kind of mediums do you use, and is there any particular favorites you have?
Yes, actually, so I became very comfortable with watercolor and ink, to an extent, and that would just be my go-to. But then I started experimenting with acrylics a little later. I still have a preference to watercolor because it's very flexible and it's easy to work with. But yeah.
I think, makes sense. So. Yeah. It's like, you can do your, it's easier in watercolor, everything.
Correct. It's easy to mix. It blends very well. It's a very easy tool and, yeah.
So what kind of, so how did you feel when your debut series, Celestial Navigation, was showcased at the Queer and Alir Art Festival? So can you tell us more about it?
Yeah, absolutely. So basically when this happened, this was the first time that I was displaying my art, right? And I was feeling very vulnerable and scared and nervous. So in fact, I didn't even tell, my family. I think only my mom came and I didn't tell my friends. I had one friend who helped me set up the space, but I didn't tell anyone. In fact, it got covered by New India Express. And when it got covered in the papers, everyone was like, you never told us that you exhibited, And I was like, yeah, I was really nervous because it was the first time I was putting myself out there. And it was an incredible experience. The community is very friendly and it was a great way for me to open. Yeah.
Okay, so as an artist, how do you think you should handle criticism?
So this is a very interesting question because criticism, it depends on where it's coming from, because especially in art, it's so subjective, right? Sometimes maybe your intentions and your ideas and thoughts just don't align with the other person. So I think the best way to do it is to hear people out, but then know what you want and what you do, because in end of the day, you're making art for yourself. You're trying to express your emotions or your thoughts and feelings, right? So if you start just to pleasing everybody via art, then you're going to fail as an artist. Whereas with design, it's the opposite. It's the most important thing, in design to please your client. That is the most important. So I guess that's the difference. Yeah.
So do you remember the first artwork you did? How did you work on it? The first thing that you actually started, or where your art journey started from?
Yeah. So I guess in college, we would be given a lot of assignments that involved, drawing and everything, and illustrating basically. So in college is when I even started really drawing a lot. And I didn't even realize it, but actually it was one of the faculty who took me, and they told me, do you realize that I'd always feel like lesser than people who are very experienced artists. You know, their skill and technique would be on point, and I was not that kind of artist. My style would be a little bit grungy or, you know, cartoony or 2D. You know, I had a specific style, and it's funny because I never told myself I should paint like or draw like that. It just came to me, you know. And that's when I realized that it's not a bad thing. It's just my style of work. And then I started becoming more confident drawing the way that I do. I think the first piece was I made this set of postcards that were inspired by a Nirvana song called Negative Creep. It's fully monotone, just black and white. And yeah, that would be my first real, you know, finished work.
Yeah, I think you've become grown a confident person. Like, pursuing something you really like is something I admire. So what do you think are the key differences between a digital design and traditional, like, artwork?
Yeah, so I think digital design is, honestly, I haven't really explored digital art that much. I haven't drawn on Procreate that much, but I do use Illustrator once in a while, you know, for illustrations. I think digital art allows you to really explore and experiment, and traditional art has to be a little bit more skill or, you know, like, practice based. It's a both are beautiful in their own way. So yeah.
So do you have any, like, liking towards specific kind of artwork or any artist? Do you have anything?
Yeah, actually I do. So I love surrealistic paintings. When you talk about, you know, art history, I love that kind of work. Now, recently I'm liking a lot of abstract acrylic works, work with a lot of texture. I feel, especially as an interior designer, you know, it not only looks great, you can interpret it. Every day it looks different, right? Like, it seems very simple, but the best thing about an abstract or a modern piece is that one day you look at it, you see something. The next day you look at it, you see something completely different, which is really interesting about abstract art. For that reason, that is definitely, you know, yeah.
Okay, so how do you think pandemic has brought changes into your career? Is there any?
There actually has been. So the first year was tough because all the markets were closed, and we rely a lot on, you know, plywood suppliers and basically suppliers for the interior work. So a lot of that was closed, and also people were not ready to, you know, invest at that point. But then I think after that 1 year of spending time in their houses, this year everybody wants to, you know, do up their houses. Suddenly they're in their house so much, they're like, why don't I have a home office? Or why don't I have a small workout space in my house? And, you know, they want to, why don't I have plants in my house, you know? So I'm noticing this year has been good in terms of work, and opportunities wise as well. Like, it's been really good, touch wood, because online also it's easy to, like, approach magazines or, you know, bigger, like, people who are higher in the industry. It's easy to reach them, you know, via social media. Earlier they were not so approachable. Yeah.
So knowing that you're also, like, a certified tattoo artist, like, I think you like exploring stuff. So do you have, like, anything which you're currently working on, any interest or any technique in particular?
So actually I'm not a certified tattoo artist. I did study tattooing at Edizumi. It's a course, it's a proper course, but it doesn't have a certificate. So I did practice under Edizumi for a while. The thing with tattooing is you need to practice every day. If you give a large break, you can't go back on skin again, you know. It's not, your hand won't be as steady. So I took a long break, but now recently I went for a ceramics course in Chennai, where I learned how to, you know, work on the wheel, you know, with pottery and stuff. So that was also really interesting. I have to think about if I want to pursue it further, but definitely, you know, as learning something new was really great because it has nothing to do with painting, you know. So literally you're at zero now. For like weeks I didn't get it at all. It just didn't come, you know. Yeah, so it was an interesting experience.
I think you literally tried out everything possible. You keep trying out stuff, which is really nice. So for budding artists, like, what do you think, how do they like overcome an art block? Like, have you had an art block?
Yeah, actually I've gone even months without painting, and suddenly that's all I'll be doing, you know. Sometimes it's just about, like, you should allow it, I guess, to happen, because sometimes you force it and it just doesn't work out, you know. But ideas come at the right time, and when it does, you just have to, like, grab it, otherwise, you know, you miss out. So I think that's it. But there are tools that you know you can use to, like, keep it going, to keep yourself inspired. For example, there's a very simple tool that I was taught in college. So basically they told us to just draw anything, like a room or whatever you'd like, and then tear that piece of paper into small pieces, and then rearrange those pieces and create something abstract, and then use that as inspiration to draw a new thing. So you've drawn some, it's a very interesting experiment, because you've drawn something that you're not, and you've just done it, you know. It's nothing that you feel really close to, you tear it and then you make something out of that. It's like, so there are tools and ways to keep yourself inspired and motivated that you can, you know, try out. But another thing you can do is just leave it and, you know, let it come sometimes. Yeah.
Okay, this idea is like super curious, like, I don't know, like, how it works, but I think we should try it once. It's like very interesting.
Yeah, definitely try it. It's interesting. Initially you're like, no, I don't want to tear this, you know, but you have to do it and it feels good. Yeah.
Okay, so what do you think about this interview and palette series from JP?
I can't wait to see the other interviews also, because this is really interesting. I was very surprised, you know. I was actually wondering how you came to know about, you know, me, or to see my work, and, you know, I want to ask you a lot of questions, because it's really interesting that you're at a college, right?
Yeah.
You're a university of three colleges?
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. So it's really great, and I think, you know, you're so young, and, like, to take that initiative, to, like, do this yourself is so good, and I'm very excited to, you know, like, be everything and see everything. Yeah.
Thank you, I'm like, yeah, it was amazing.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am, for coming, spending your valuable time, and we wish you all the best for anything new you're doing and any crazy ideas you're up to. And thank you.
Thank you so much, Shreya. Bye.